Hi, it's Jamie, Progressive number one, number two employee. Leave a message at the... Hey, Jamie, it's me, Jamie. This is your daily pep talk. I know it's been rough going ever since people found out about your a cappella group, Mad Harmony, but you will bounce back. I mean, you're the guy always helping people find coverage options with the Name Your Price tool. It should be you giving me the pep talk. Now get out there, hit that high note, and take Mad Harmony all the way to nationals this year! Sorry, this is pitchy.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Blog Talk Radio.
Hey, it's your girl Coco Filipina from NC Rap Scene and Turnt Tuesday. And I'm giving a big shout out to King Eric, Miss Chinchilla, Sandman, off of Off the Cuff Radio. You are now tuned in.
All right.
Hey, it's your girl Coco Filipina from NC Rap Scene, and I'm giving a big shout out to King Eric, Miss Chinchilla, Illa R, the Sandman, and Off the Cuff Radio. Yeah.
Guy ain't drunk. I made the beat when I was drunk, though. Y'all don't know me. My name's TC.
Grams, double up, ounces, birds, chickens, eagles, kilos, bricks, boulders, cake, weight, hard, soft. Just hit me on my Blackberry. Grams, double up, ounces, birds, chickens, eagles, kilos, bricks, boulders, cake, weight, hard, soft. Just hit me on my
Pyrex vision with the arm and the hammer. Vax seal, Rico, thumper and a scanner. Microwave stovetop, any way you want it. Wrist game dishes when it's potent. Just call me Dope Gang Dollar. Hefe on the scene, tuck tight, knee Impala. Yeah, money counters on the table. Cellophane and digital rulers, we getting table for show. Bone white with the fish scale. Quota chickens to the birds going airmail. Bought my paper, boy, hit me on the text. Baby in a book, I'll figure out the rest. Whoa, mountain and a razor, yeah. Beanie with the Levi's, hoodie and a taser. A killer kit for the block, Blackberry buzzing, got a bust knock.
Grams, double up, ounces, birds, chickens, eagles, kilos, bricks, boulders, cake, weight, hard, soft. Just hit me on my Blackberry. Grams, double up, ounces, birds, chickens, eagles, kilos, bricks, boulders, cake, weight, hard, soft. Hit me on my
iPhone, Metro, Verizon, Cricket, prepaid boost, T-Mobile, this chicken, tell him, hit me on my Blackberry, this one is a throwaway, it really don't matter cause I be talking baseball, anyway, got word on them birds, Migo got them by the flocks, took it to the hood, that be busting down the rocks, I'm a deep boy, Denise packs me racks, got the thirsty, just looking in the fence, trying to check,
get hands, hoes, boats, even doubler, AT&T package, come get that bundle, go hit the Blackberry, better get the iPhone, matter of fact, the Metro, meet you in the ghetto, right there by Wilson, next door to so-and-so, never mention name or places, really on these phones though, pounds, pharmaceuticals, prick-a, tell me what you trying to get, I tell you what the info,
grams, double up, ounces, birds, chickens, eagles, kilos, bricks, boulders, cake, weight, hard, soft, just hit me on my Blackberry, grams, double up, ounces, birds, chickens, eagles, kilos, bricks, boulders, cake, weight, hard, soft,
Mr. Dope Man, call me Mr. Dope Man. That good credit get you fronted when you're broke, man. I got the double up, or you could buy the whole thing. Connect bringing in bricks of the dope beans to the trying to get it. I'm serving everybody, you can hit me for the business. If you want it, I can get it. Had the plug since they lined up the block, cause the things love it. Yeah, I'm a hustler, so you know it's strapped up. But if you trigger finger, don't you try to act up and get clapped up trying to set the jack up. Well, how you looking like these bricks all wrapped up? I got the line on Peruvian cake. No pineapple dope, only Snow White flakes. Some people wanna hate cause they working with that B12 or that soda, but the fiends know what we sell.
Rams, double up, ounces, birds, chickens, eagles, kilos, bricks, boulders, cake, weight, hard, soft. Just hit me on my Blackberry. Grams, double up, ounces, birds, chickens, eagles, kilos, bricks, boulders, cake, weight, hard, soft. Just hit me on my Blackberry.
I told your niggas to lay low key. This song is for the lost OG.
Yeah.
I smell the shit up, nigga. Blow it up. Straight boy. Sipping on my Hennessy. Watching from a distance. Praying for the better days.
Yeah.
We don't hustle by force, cause my father freaks. Nobody does it better like my OGs. Hustling in the blood, daylight. Praying for the better days. Rest in peace for my niggas. We lost in the game. Teardrops, got two back shots. Five times, still breathing, nigga. Las Vegas, why still? Beat trash, took it on. Money E back, easy E. Notorious B.I.G. Bro, Eric Garner, Michael Jackson, Big Fun, Da Green, Gaddafi, Afeni, Shakur, Michael Verdi, the Don, the icon, you were gone, but we still a motherfucking team. Thug, rival, rapid, drug the way. African nations, don't stop me, new thug, find it. Watch me sitting on the throne like African king. Take it up, break it down, rest the peace.
You took a loss when you lived in the hood. Good job, and respect was all good. Now your soul have been set free. Much respect to the lost OGs. You took the loss when you lived in the hood. Stood tall and respect was all good. Now your soul have been set free. Much respect to the lost OGs.
Much respect to the lost OGs. All my niggas forever, cause they living through me. Whoever shot Tupac, 1,000 deaths to the killer. On your last day breathing, just respecting my nigga. Through the fire and the flames, pleasure and pain. Sunshine becomes rain when niggas fuck up the game. This outlaw lifestyle ain't nothing to play with. All lives matter, so I'm preaching one nation. To the fallen OGs, now your soul set free. I'm still down here fighting, about to earn my wings. Donald Trump ain't stopping shit, I've been surviving forever. No SSI, welfare or debit. So I guess I'm just another statistic trying to make a living. Living in hell, watching murders and drug dealers. I'd rather stand for something than fall for everything. Rest in peace to the lost OGs in the game.
You took the loss when you lived in the hood. Good job and respect was all good. Now your soul have been set free. Much respect to the lost OGs. You took the loss when you lived in the hood.
All respect was all good. Now your soul has been set free. Much respect to the lost OGs. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. To all the OGs who didn't sell out for a field. Kept it real for the youngsters who's coming up in the street. If you didn't, who the fuck would a player like me be? Probably simping or on the corner nickel picking. Trying to get my hands on the dime, but they ain't reaching. Without the mainframe, all they getting is some window pane. Crying on the bus, cause they don't know how to maintain. Ain't shit changed, but some players in the game. Man, we took a loss, but we on the game. It's a king came, mental knowledge for your brain. Give me your ink pen and watch me bleed off up on my page. R.I.P. the Tupac, R.I.P. the Breed. Gotta get mine, but never like a dope fiend. Ain't sipping surfing, popping pills for the birds. I'm only smoking earth and pouring liquor on the curb.
About, you know, that's how life is. Black life matter. You know what it is for the OGs that lost in the street. Soldiers, all the angels working from the deep. You know what it is, baby.
No racist,
I don't like
no matter what your race is.
No matter,
a racist is a racist.
It is.
We all God's children, please explain that to me.
Please.
You reap what you sow.
That's something you can't escape. I can't let this go, so I hold on to my faith. No race should have a privilege. Tell me, how can that be? When we all God children, please blame that to me. You reap what you sow. That's something you can't escape. I can't let this go, so I hold on to my faith.
I don't hate white folks. I just don't like no races.
I don't like
no matter what your race is.
No matter.
A racist is a racist.
Always thinking bigger. It's the black of the berry, the sweeter the juice, and who was bitter? A race controls another race, but then they won't admit it. They give us money and take it back as soon as we spend it. Stuck in society and I ain't got privilege. Listen, taking my woman to get chicken and biscuits and kick it, but dig it, racists don't want to serve my kind. But it really hurts their eyes to observe my shine. We only made equal, but we all are still people. After WW2, nobody want to see the sequel. Got the cops acting nervous and it got me feeling evil, cause they make it seem like my skin color is illegal. If the shoe was on the other foot, would you be just another crook who needs some money on the books? Police won't let you off the hook. Streets is talking, you should look. We taking back what you took. Listen to the chorus, but we still won't let you off the hook.
I don't hate white folks. I just don't like no races.
I don't like
no matter what your race is.
No matter.
A racist is a racist.
Made us crack a smile. So the slaves used to say, here come the when it came around. Yeah, that's the definition. Look it up in the dictionary. And truth is contrary to popular belief. We black folks want more than what's in these streets. Ain't asking for no handout, just an equal opportunity in employment, housing, education. Face it, it's racist in this country and a lot of black buffoonery. Lord knows at night, I pray for black unity. We still here through the pores of Jim Crow trying to shame us. How you gonna blame us? They only love us when we're famous. They only love us when we're famous.
I don't hate white folks. I just don't like no racist.
I don't like them.
No matter what your race is.
No matter.
A racist is a racist.
Y'all, this is your boy King Eric the Great, and you are now tuned in at Off the Cuff Radio.
That's right, and we have Bay Area producer, legend in this game, my man DJ TC on the line. You there, brother?
What up with you, brother? Can you hear me?
Man, hold on. Before we get this, I hear you real well. Before I get this started, we got to give you a round of ovation just based off the longevity alone. That's what we do here.
Oh, well, thank you very much, man. Appreciate that.
That's right, man. This is a special two-hour show. First hour here, we got DJ TC right here. In the second hour, we're going to be featuring other Bay Area MC, producer, Shady Nate. So let's get on to it. Call number is 1-619-924-0703 if you want to chop it up. And let's get this thing under control. How you doing out there, brother?
Man, out here hanging in this heat, man. It's burning up in Frisco right now, man. It'll never get like this.
Man, we getting drenched out here from this crazy hurricane weather, man. I'm just holding on for dear life, hoping that this show goes
Yeah, man, that hurricane ain't no joke, man. You know, we get them earthquakes from time to time, but it ain't been one in a minute. But the way this weather acting, man, I know it's one coming.
Ooh, it's very unpredictable, man. I'm trying to stay dry the best way possible. I'm not going anywhere.
There you go.
I'm playing this game smart. So I just go ahead and choose to chop it up with y'all.
That's right. Hey, you got to get your time in somehow, shit.
Exactly. Make it feel worthwhile, man. And it's an honor for you to be a part of this, man, because a lot of people don't know enough about too much about your resume, especially our core audience that's just following through. So you care to give the people like a brief background of the contribution that you made to this game?
I mean, man, just grinding, man, in it, man. I've been in the game since 86, 87. Started off with a cat out of Frisco here, out of Hunters Point named Fly Moore. Me and Fly Moore used to get down back in the day, talent shows, making tapes, giving them out, selling them in the neighborhood, just doing different stuff, you know what I'm saying? We cut school, come to the house, get on the four track in 808 and start making some hits, man. You know, we just started off like that. And then just moved on, man. From there, we put out a cassette with Fly Moore, and then I went on with these other guys, Huey MC. Came out with Huey MC. Man, we did that at Bankroll Studio when I started working at that joint out here in San Francisco. And just from Huey MC and went from Totally Insane, RBL, 11-5, Herm Lewis, just a bunch of groups from the Bay, man. Rapping Forte, Dre Dogg, Andre Nicotina. Just countless numbers of groups that just came out of Frisco. And there was some cats from other spots, East Bay, other places, worked with the great Mac Dre. Did some work with Tretch from Naughty by Nature. Did some work with, you know, just the other cats just branching out, man. So since 86, man, just been grinding in the game, DJing and serving up these beats, man, trying to make this hit music, you know?
That's what it do, man. Now, before we get to continue, I think we have a caller right here that we want to chop it up with. It's a 757 caller. If you have any questions to shoot at my man right here, DJ TC. You on?
What up, what up? 202 down from the east to the west, putting it down. Much respect to you, the legend, DJ TC. And what up, E? You know who this is. You know who this is, King Eric? What up, going?
What's
going on, man?
How you doing, man?
What's going on, man? First off, Mr. DJ TC, the contributions, I mean, in terms of the Bay Area, I mean, thank you first and foremost so much for what you've done. And, I mean, how does it feel to see that whole, to be part of that whole movement from the Bay Area in terms of going from the early, from watching it and being a part of it from the early days of with Too Short to the late great Mac Dre to to E-40 to, I mean, like you said, you know, Dre Dogg, Andre Nicotina, you know, for a lot of heads out there who don't remember that joint, you know, the album I Hate You With a Passion.
Yes,
I mean, you know, I mean, it just a new guys, like, you know, Filthy Rich, Cookie Money, Shady Nate, you know, Lil Blood, Stevie Joe. How does it feel to just watch the Bay Area just go from the different evolutions of sound, you know, from the East Bay pimp funk to the hyphy,
right,
kind of like the
right
new wave right now?
I mean, man, it's a trip just watching all the new cats, because it was like, I was worried for a minute, man. It was like, it was a rush, like in the early 90s, and from 90 to about 95, 96, it was a bunch of great stuff coming out, man. E-40,
oh, man.
RBL, just a bunch of groups. They had 415, Richie Rich and D-Lo, and MC Cool. And
oh, yeah, what about Young
Short.
Black Brother Records, Mac Maul and all that?
Oh,
yeah,
man,
Wayne.
Come on, Mac Maul. Man, come on, man. Ray Love. I mean, it was just, like,
yes,
I say, it was just
yes,
a bunch of greatness. And then around 96, 95, no, about 96, 97, it kind of slowed down. Like, what happened, I think, around that time, like, that generation of cats that was supposed to be rapping ended up getting into the gang banging and, you know, the shooting,
right,
and all the killing and stuff that was going on. So we kind of lost the moment there. And, like, the last couple of groups that survived that was Hitman from RBL and 11-5 from right here in Hunters
right
Point, where I'm from. That group I helped create. And then for a minute
right
there, it was kind of quiet. And then around, I guess, 98, 99, Mac Dre and them started coming back around. Mr. Fab and them started coming around. You know what I'm saying? So it started turning into another movement. And it went in another direction. And I kind of backed off and fell off back then. I was just straight in the studio engineering. I wasn't doing nothing. So I watched them cats come in the game. It gave a whole nother energy, brought the Bay back. You know what I'm saying? Now, mind you, this whole time all this is going on, the main two people were still there, E-40 and Too Short. Them two dudes,
right.
Man, they stuck it out and hung it up. Man, them two cats stuck it out throughout that whole period. I give them dudes credit for that big time. So they seen the different movement from the hardcore funk bass lines and all the sampling and stuff we used to do back in the day to now it's more up-tempo and dancing with the hypey movement and all that stuff started cracking off. So you get groups like Three Times Crazy, Keek Sneak and them, and all these other groups start coming around. Man, it changed the whole little platform. So when Fab and all them cats came around, I was kind of like in the background, still getting, you know, my love and respect from them cats. So it was just, you know, just watching that evolution. And then to see what came out of that, which is like you say, the Stevie Joes and all these other cats that's out now. I'm a fan of Stevie Joe. He came to the house and did some stuff. That dude is very professional. So it's like cats like that, man. And I love the direction and see where it's going right now. With a lot of these cats, there's a lot of hot artists out there right now doing it, man. I can't do nothing but love it and respect it. As long as they ain't messing up the game. But for a minute there, man, from like 96 to like 98, 99, I was worried, man. It was ugly.
Well, definitely. And I think Eric would agree with this as well, because me and him talk about this all the time, just watching evolution, because the Bay Area, and we're old enough and, you know, to know when that whole, this is back in the day when Rap City was Rap City, you know, and out here
right.
In Virginia, Hampton Roads area where I live, I was exposed to so much. You know, I remember, you know, Drew Down, you know, Baby Bubba. I remember, you know, Dre Dawg's Situation Critical. I remember Three Times
right.
Crazy, Keep It On The Real. I remember Ray Dawg's Last
right.
Night, you know, Mac Maul, Sick With This. You know, and like I said, you know, just watching, you know, the new generation, you know, I mean, I was around when SIBO started making his come up, you know, of course, in those
right.
years, and Mac Dre did drop Too Hard For The Radio in 89. Did his little vacation, came back, and Rompilation was in full, you know, full go.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it's just everything that y'all did, I think is so underappreciated in terms of the impact that y'all had. I mean, hell, E-40 for what he did with his language, you know,
man, come on, man.
From the turf. I mean, little Yachty talking about he said broccoli first when E-40 was sitting broccoli on Hall of Game, you know, back in the
come
day.
Come on, man. You said broccoli, babe. Man, come on, man. Everybody know where that crazy language come from, man. Everybody, come on. It's Frisco, Vallejo, Oakland, you know what I'm saying? It comes from the players and the old school pimps and all that stuff back in the day. A lot of player stuff going on out here in the Bay, unlike a lot of people think. It's a lot of player, you know, cats pimping and ooh, and doing all that little stuff, you know what I'm saying? So that's where that language comes from, that ability to run your mouth when you really ain't supposed to really be saying nothing, but sometimes you just need that attention and you run your mouth. And that's what, man, that's Bay Cats is known for that, man. Left to right, man. That's what they do. Fillmore Cats, Hunters Point Cats, man, Oakland, Vallejo, Richmond, man, you just talk to these cats, man, these rappers and stuff, man. You start hearing some of the language and you be like, okay, you got to remind them you're talking to, you're getting interviewed here. You're not in the woman's ear right now. You know, some of these cats will talk to you kind of crazy. You'd be like, hey, bro, you're talking to me right now. You can't run that on me. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, that's just the game of the Bay, man. That's what cats did, man. That's what they do. And also, you know, the Bay cats, man, the problem with a lot of us, man, is that you be in the rap game and you be real tough, you have a little success, but you also got this other hustle going on. And it's always
right,
been like
right.
that with Bay Cats. Costs so much to live out here. You can't just make rap money and live out here. Very hard to do. So a lot of cats got other hustles. You know what I'm saying? Job, whatever, you know, whatever they do. But you got to have 2-3 hustles. So you think a cat fell off, he's like, nah, he just on his other hustle right now. You know what I'm saying? He ain't in the rap shit right now. He get back to rapping later, but right now he got to take care of his other thing.
Oh, most definitely.
Now, hold on one second. I think we have all the co-hosts. My man, Illar the Sad Man in the building.
Where you at, my man?
1212.
That's right.
He's
we
here.
Have the legendary DJ TC in the building, man. Huge Bay Area contributor.
Okay. What's going on, brother?
What's going on with your boss?
Man, your name traveled all the way out to the Bronx like a long time ago, my dude. I'm not even going to hold you. So it's definitely a privilege to talk to you. Like, you like a legend out here, my dude.
No, appreciate you, man. Appreciate that very much, man. Just trying to keep it grinding for y'all, man.
Definitely.
Really, man, just trying to keep pushing this movement. You know, T's, I've been away from the game for a minute, and it was like, everybody like, what's up, T, you and your OG Cats, y'all not coming back? It's like, man, all right, I can do something real quick, because the game is kind of goofy around here a little bit, and, like, our radio stations don't play us at all, you know what I'm saying? They don't give these cats too much of a time, you know, you can't get an interview like this on station out here in the Bay, you know what I'm saying? On the big ones. And it's like, all right, so what I did was,
let them know, all know in the Bay. Hit us up, Walter Cuff Radio, man.
Definitely. I'm, you know, come on, man. I'm going to rep that big time. Don't worry about that. But
I'm
saying is just like, the Bay, man, is so funny out here, man. We consumers out here. It's so much. It's like with the game, like with the artists and stuff. It's kind of like crabs in a barrel. They scared to let one cat get on top, and think he gonna run off and leave them behind all the rest of them. Instead of supporting that cat and pushing him forward, a lot of times these brothers start hating on the cat, you know. And that it's just an ugly part of the game out here in Frisco, basically, really in Frisco. So it's like right now, the deputy Prezi got a real. He got a nephew out here named Prezi. He got a real hot song called Do Better. And a lot of cats are starting to hate on this dude, but they can't do nothing about it because he got some muscle behind him. But still, from the talk from some of the other artists don't be cool, though, and I don't understand why. Y'all need to be pushing this brother instead of hating on him. And I'm trying to teach this.
That's some crazy shit to hit on somebody that got a song called Do Better. It's not like the name of his song is called I Got Money Bitches or I Got Bitches and Money. Nah, he got a song from the title, it's like he's influencing everybody to better themselves.
Yeah, exactly. I guess a lot of them be mad because they didn't make it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay, if you had better material, you wouldn't have time to be worried about what this brother doing, you know?
It's not really only that, because people got to understand too, like, yeah, you know, it's cool to make it in the industry and all that, but at the same token, you know, don't look at this as a paycheck. If you want to do this,
right.
If you want to do this, you're going to want to do this just for the love of it regardless. But if a paycheck comes with it, then that's supposed to be a plus.
That's supposed to
be your end game.
Hey, I tell cats like this, man, with this music thing, if I make a buck or not, I'm still going to throw something out there. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I've been in this game so long, I didn't see cats come and go. I saw all the cats who was trying to make a quick buck come and go. You know what I'm saying? So I know when it's real, when people real about the music and it's in it, it's their passion, it's their art. You know what I'm saying? If it ain't your passion and it ain't your art, you just doing it for a quick dollar, you're not going to last 2 weeks. You're not going to get what you're looking for out of this.
Definitely. And I got to say what's up to Illar. Illar, what's going on, man? It's Thomas in Virginia. What's going on, man?
What's going on, my dude? How you feeling?
Chilling. I'm good. And I think also, what OG was saying is, and I think, you know, and of course with Eric's permission and your permission to mention this as well, I think we would all be remiss. The Mozzie Sebo situation from last week, in terms of the beef,
You know, Mozzie came with New Era, New King. Sebo had Body for Body. We all know about what happened with the shooting on Sebo's video set last week. Four people shot, one fatally, and three injured.
We also friends definitely go out, you know, because we was cracking jokes about it way before it even happened.
Right.
We was cracking jokes here and there about the whole Sebo and Mozzie beat. But everybody got to understand, this is all for entertainment. We don't wish no harm on anybody, especially when it comes to music. We don't wish no harm or death on anybody. It was all for entertainment. And our prayers go out to the wounded victims out there, what may have you.
That's Sacramento. That's like an hour and a half away from me. So it's like, that's I can't really speak up on that. I don't even know the real logistics of what's going on in that. I see the young cat, he got fired. You know what I'm saying? But the OG
like,
also got fired. It's
people,
like, so why? My whole thing is why y'all couldn't?
Why couldn't they just get along though
and make it work for the city? You know, Sacramento. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I was saying the same thing. But from what I was told, it's like basically Mozzie was being reckless out the mouth towards Sebo, you know, young dudes coming at the old school, what they would like to call the old school or whatever. And you already know it's going to be a clash with that because, you know, young head coming at an old head.
Oh yeah, I'm trying to hear that.
Like, what you mean, like, boy? I've been doing this since
she was in diapers. Right. But that thing, man, that's something I can't really study, man, because we don't have that problem like here in Frisco. Like the youngsters, pretty much respect all OGs in the game. Like, you know, you'll never hear none of these new cats come at Black C from RBL. You know what I'm saying? You'll never hear none of them get at Huey MC or get at none of the older rappers, 11, you know, the groups from here, from Frisco, Hunters Point, and Fillmore. You know what I'm saying? It's like you'll never see none of these young cats on wax attack JT the bigger figure. None of these cats. You know what I'm saying? It's a respect
that. I'm so glad that you brought that in the forefront because, you know, we have a whole bunch of listeners here, and, you know, some of our listeners is the youngins. And they need to learn that, you know, it's not always cool to get at, you know, the proprietors or the pioneers.
Right.
You know, just to basically, I guess, sound cool because, believe it or not, when it comes to the young talent, having a young talent out here, they get a kick out of making fun of the older, you know, the talent that was before them. They get a kick out of that. Like, oh, yo, you clown that dude, son. You fake clown that dude. Yeah, he an old dude, B. Fuck that nigga.
Right. That don't happen out here in Frisco, man. It's more respect. It's more paying homage than any kind of disrespect going on as far as, like, especially with the music, you know. Street stuff is street stuff. You got to leave that where it is. But musically, it don't happen in Frisco. The younger cats give it up to the OGs in Frisco. It's to the point now they really start to pay homage and asking the older cats, like, can I redo your song? Can I do this? You know what I'm saying? That type of stuff. It ain't even about them trying to diss or nothing. They really like giving it up and paying homage. And I give it to the young cats for being respectable. A lot of them was raised right. Raised by the OGs correct, you know?
Well, I mean, definitely in terms of the soundtrack that you helped lay the template, how does that pretty much, to see other guys like Trax A Million and DJ Fresh, the world's freshest, to see them come into the game? I mean, and they just basically expanded on that panoramic type of, fantastic that you laid down. I mean, how does it, I mean, did you ever know that this influence that you had was going to, I mean, almost 30 years later and beyond, is still going to be such the template for it is.
I'm so happy for all them cats, man. But, like, come on, man. Them dudes is making nice tracks. As long as the music stay good, man, I don't have a problem with it at all. I'll go party right along with them. And that's what we did, man. When we was coming up, man, it was all about, man, going to get girls, man. We was making music to get bras. We weren't making music for nothing else. You know what I'm saying? If we can go to the club and you hear a lady say, "Hey, that's my song." Yeah, okay. There it is right there. That's what we want. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man. I'm just keeping it real, man. And that's what it was all about, man. We was just making music to get girls. That's why a lot of our hits are the nice songs we had. RBL, Don't Give Me No Bammer Weed, 11-5 Garcia Vegas, yeah. These different songs like that with up-tempo songs. Those were for the girls, man. That wasn't for us.
And the new track,
so that's what we
did
for.
The Hit Me on the Blackberry track we just played, it kind of restored that old feeling.
Hey, and that's what we was trying. We were definitely trying to do that. I made it a point, no auto tunes, no extra studio tricks, no, you know, extra Pro Tools, nothing. I just want to make a nice track. Found the hook. Hey, I got the hook. If you laugh, Ice Cube movie. What's Ice Cube movie called? Janky Promoters.
Yeah,
I got the hook from Janky Promoters. When the mom and the auntie or whatever was in there cooking up the dope or whatever. Yeah, that's where I got the hook from. So it was like, once I got that laid down, I got the Hood Stars on it, got Black Sea, and it took me a while to find the first cat to who was I going to put on it first. It took me damn near a year. Called my boy Mag 10 for Totally Insane, like $10. Come on, baby, jump on this for me. He came out of retirement. I got you. Nothing. Did that. Had a ball, man. Had fun doing it with these guys. Shot the video. The video's on YouTube. If y'all ain't seen it, go check it out. It's nice, man. Hit me on my Blackberry. And we had a ball, man, just putting it all together. We had fun. So my next song I got coming up, I'm waiting on this third guy. I can't tell y'all who it's going to be, but I got Forte on the first verse, Tretch from Naughty by Nature on the second verse, and I'm waiting on this last dude to jump on it so I can drop this one and give it to you. So hopefully in the next week or two, you'll be getting another single from me.
Yeah, we're going to definitely push that for you.
Man, appreciate it, man. It's all appreciated, man. I mean, I know, just being an old dude, man. Oh, another thing I want to say, man, check this out. Just being an old dude, now that I'm jumping back in this game, this is so funny, man. I don't know none of these young cats, like, that's had all these different, the blog spots, the magazines, and all this different stuff, right? So, you got to go to this person to get it popping. You got to go to that person to get it popping. I'm like, who the hell is that? And why do I got to go to them? You know what I'm saying? I don't know who they are. They don't know who I am. So we sitting there looking at each other stupid as hell. You know what I'm saying? It's like, so he going to ask me for some money. I'm going to be like, for money for what? You know what I'm saying? It's a stalemate right now with these cats. I got to get to know these young cats now. And a lot of them is little nerdy white dudes. All right. That's cool. You hip-hop head. You running this magazine. Are you running this internet page or whatever? Is all good. It's weird though now to me, like, okay, I gotta reset my mind on how to do this, you know what I'm saying? Back in the day, we used to just turn our daddy into the record company and they handle everything.
Yeah,
it's like,
go
now
to
I gotta go out
store,
here and grind and connect with these people.
Yeah, you go to a record store, you see your uncle or your auntie up there, you can just go to them.
Exactly. You got the moms and pops. You direct it. It's a meeting. You know these people. I don't know these cats, man. This stuff is crazy right now. I had to turn to my boy Fleetwood. Like, Fleet, what am I supposed to do? You out here pushing. You've been grinding. I'm going to run you through these stations and run you through this and run you through that. I appreciate it. But my G, you know, I had to get with Fleetwood, like, to get it going. You know what I'm saying? And we trying to move it around a little bit around.
Yeah, he's been heavy vocal in pushing this movement.
Oh, man, you know, I love that dude, man. That's my guy.
I think definitely, too, and, you know, Lady Chinchilla, you know, the female host who hosts this as well, along with Eric and Ella and myself, we all recognize how important it is for the OG, such as yourself, who laid down the foundation, and how there has to be that bridge that connects the new to the old. And there are two things that we have always talked about, you know, on their show about this. Number one, two things that need to stop. Number one, rap music is the only genre where they try to force out the artists trying to say that their swag is no longer needed, i.e.
that nonsense Lonzo Ball said today. And then also to the publications who are not necessarily reaching back to keep the history alive in terms of really, you know, just your area is so rich in Hunter's Point. I mean, you know, you have also San Quentin from there as well, you know, and also San Francisco, the Fillmore District. For a lot of heads who really got deep into history, I tell the heads who really know about the pimping, you know, pedigree of it on the turf, ask about, you know, Fillmore Slim.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and it's important that they're reaching out to you because you were part of that.
Right.
And you can give them, you are the living, breathing history over 30 years of what has come, you know, over what has come through the game, you know?
Oh, man. Shoot. Like I say, man, just happy to still be around, being able to do this, man, and make music now that people can be like, okay, the OGs is kind of back. They ain't went nowhere, you know what I'm saying? And that's my whole purpose of the project I'm putting together now. It's like, we're going to teach cats a little history lesson. Like, okay, it didn't start when you started rapping. It was something before you. And I'm not mad at them for not knowing because they just ignorant to it. They wasn't taught, you know what I'm saying? Somebody got to show them that there was cats before them. Your uncle used to rap. Yes, he did. He was hard back in the day. You know what I'm saying? That type of stuff. Like, your cousin Andre Nicotina, your big cousin Andre Nicotina, still on tour. He's still getting money off this. Like, you know, that type of stuff. And these young cats got to see it. They got to see it and understand it.
That's facts, man. So what's been the critical responses to the new record that y'all dropped so far?
So far, man, I haven't received anything negative. I mean, it's been cool. We played in the club. We get nice response. Girls are dancing to it. I don't know if it's just because I'm standing there or not. But, yeah, it's been pretty good response, man. The visual, the video, they get to see all the couple of OG cats I got on there. And I've been getting great response, man. I got to get my numbers up, but as far as YouTube go and that type of crap, but we're working on it.
Just learning the whole new technology.
Exactly. So it's like I'm starting from scratch, and I love it because it's all new. I get to learn again.
That's what it is, man. Now, with the name of this, what's the name of this up-and-coming album that you drop? Is it going to be like a compilation or?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it got to be because man, it got to be a come because I don't rap, you know. So it's just going to be, you know, I still got to come up with the title for it. But the artist list I got on there is a list of OGs. Like, if you're really in the Bay Area rap, or mainly Frisco rap, you're going to be like, this dude is pulling out some cats. We ain't heard these voices in years. Like, groups Cold World Hustlers and Big Quint from UDI. I mean, you know, just local cats from around here that used to rap back in the day. Selsky and just Boy Here Rick, and I might have some old Kugner verses laying around I might pull out. I still got C Fresh. I got, you know, all these cats from back in the day, man, from Frisco. So that's what I'm pulling from on this album.
Okay.
So right now we just right now we're just putting the tracks together, man, and I just want everybody to hear these voices they ain't heard in years and how they still got it. They can still go if they wanted to, but such is life. You got kids with grandfathers now. You know what I'm saying? You worried about your mortgage. You got, you know, you got things you got things to deal with now as a grown man. So, yeah, that's what we're doing right now. And there's no pressure this time. We having fun doing it. We had our own time doing it. You know what I'm saying? So there's no pressure from a label or from this person to that person to be successful. We can just go out and make music we like and put it out there. And if it happens, it happens. If it don't, it don't. No problem.
Yeah, and that's a good thing because y'all not really focusing on numbers. Y'all just wanted to put a project together just for the old fan base to touch in, and it's less pressure. And usually a record
And man,
like
and
that.
That's...
Hey, since you said the key word fan base. It's like, man, what happened to our old fan base? Where's all them people at? They used to listen to us back in the day. We want to pull them back out and see what's going on. So we're going to figure it out, and then we're going to throw a nice big one-night showcase where I'm going to probably get it like me DJing in a live band, and I'm bringing all these cats out on stage for one night only.
Oh,
and
we're
going to rock. We're going to rock one of their old songs, and we're going to rock the new songs, you know?
Yeah.
That type of stuff. So that's the goal. That's the main objective is to have that one night. Now, one last night. Let's do it, fellas, all of us. You know what I'm saying?
That's a sight to see like that. All those legends in one spot. Y'all better get your Instagram photos ready. Y'all better get your Facebook Live ready. That's a legendary moment right there. You may not get this
now. Man, come on, man. That's the ultimate goal, to get everybody there, man, and just let's bang out a nice live show for these cats and show them how to do it. And make sure we invite every last one of the youngsters, all these up-and-coming cats. Come see this show. This is a show, y'all.
I mean,
look,
that's what it is. Now, I looked up too that you did some work with Master P when he was out there in the Bay on the West Coast Bad Boys project.
Oh yeah, West Coast Bad Boy 1 and 2. I never did get my gold plaques, but I produced the 11-5 track, and what else I did on that thing? Cool Nut, Tell Me Something Good track. There's a couple other tracks I helped out on that album, on both of them albums, man. Another good dude, man. Master P, another good dude. You know, man, that dude, whew, boy, I watched it. We watched that whole situation. That dude came from, he brought it from Richmond all the way up to where he got it now. Man, serious.
And I think a lot of people who have not listened to a lot of P's early stuff, who don't know the total history of it. I mean, you know, No Limit Records originally, you know, did start in Richmond, California from the record store. You know, when you listen to, you know, the first true album, True to the Game in 1995, you know, of course you had the albums before that, Mama's Bad Boy, you know,
right.
The Ghetto's Trying to Kill Me.
Kill Me, all that, man.
Die, you
Come
know,
on, man.
But definitely with, I think True, the first True album, you know, was definitely, I think, it was so much of the Bay involved in that, obviously, before he came back to Louisiana, kind of fine-tuned, you know, that sound there. But I mean, to see him do that, I mean, did you know that P was going to be what he is today? Did you know it was going? Did you know No Limit was going to become the juggernaut for that time?
No, we didn't have a clue. We was on the road with I was on the road with 11-5, and we was doing shows and stuff, and we happened to like bump into a few shows with Master P and them. And this was like right when they signed with the Priority deal, so they was about to blow up or whatever. So we did like Spokane, Washington, Seattle. We did a few stops with them cats, man. Man, we had so much fun just kicking and hanging out. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, this dude had a drive though. You can see his drive. Like, he's like, man, I'm supposed to get out of here, man. He's like, I gotta go. He's like, it ain't happening fast enough for me here. He was like, He said, I gotta take this Bay Funk and go where I got to go back home. And that's what he did, man. And it took off from there.
But definitely, because I was younger when Bout It, because I first heard about it, you know, and I'm older. I first heard about it in 1995, and I had never heard anything like that before. That was when Beats by the Pound was doing
incredible.
Their production.
Yeah.
You know, and I was like, oh my God, it's like, I mean, you know, from Rich, you know what I mean? I represent. Where them killers at? I mean, I'm like, it was like from Richmond, California, all the way back to New Orleans. That murder capital of the world's a fool. Watch your back. I'm like, and you know, it's like Eric was. Yeah, it's
but
like
now,
we never
he was
heard
telling
anything
us,
like that.
But then, though, even then, he was telling us about this bounce music. We didn't know what it was.
Right.
We were, you know, in New Orleans, whatever.
Bounce.
He was like, that's Mia X thing. I guess Mia X was she from Michigan or something? I forgot where Mia was from.
Uh,
I think she's originally from Louisiana.
From?
She's
from Louisiana,
New Orleans,
okay.
Cali,
well, she picked up the bounce music. She picked up the bounce music from somewhere and brought it to Pete. And that's what about it. That yeah, he was talking about that when we was on the airplane. Like, hey, man, it's the music, man. I first go do this. I got this bounce song. We like, what the hell is bounce? You're like, y'all see? You know what I'm saying, basically? Like, man, that shit came out. I was like, oh, that's what he was talking about. Okay. It got that Cali sound, but the I was like, okay, all right. He got something there. Yeah, that dude, he used to always complain to us, like, man, I don't know how y'all selling all them records with all them samples, man. Like, Pete, man, that's just what we do. That's our thing, man. Y'all got all them damn samples, man. Y'all killing the game, though. You're like, man, he's like, man, I didn't think that stuff would move like that. I was like, Pete, that shit was flying off the shelf at the time. We was killing him. But Pete, man,
like
Pete's a good dude, man. Good dude, man. Real good dude.
I mean, but definite. I mean, and also, too, you were talking about some of the younger heads. Are you familiar with Cookie Money out of Oakland and all, you know, his brand, you know, in terms of how he's making his come up now, in terms of being the next generation?
I've heard of him. Yeah, I've heard of him. I haven't heard his material yet. I haven't heard the music yet. I mean, it's so much music, man. It's like, it's hard to hear it all. You're like, okay, you really got to sit down and go on YouTube and search this stuff out. Like, it's so much music, man. SoundCloud, man. It'll take up your whole day.
Exactly.
It will literally take up your whole day.
They got so many blogs and web pages and stuff. It's like an open library now. It ain't like you're waiting on different networks to play you stuff.
Man, it's SoundCloud, Dat Piff, all these different spots. It's like, dude, I can't keep up. Every time I go DJ at the spot, Sam Jordan's out here in Frisco, a youngster, always come and play this by that person. I got to go look it up and pull it down and download it real quick, you know what I'm saying, on the spot to find it. Like, okay, that's a new hot thing. All right, cool, no problem. It's like, man, it's just so much stuff, and the problem I'm having with it, though, is it's standing the test of time. Like, will I be playing this song 10 years from now and get a response? It's like, I can play, like, RBL now and get a response. I can play 11.5 now and get a response. You know what I'm saying? But I'm worried about the music that's being made now. Will I play this music 10 years from now and people still respond to it? That's what I want to see.
You know, and it's funny because in Oakland, you know, as we watch the Bay Area and myself, you know, being on this side of the, you know, United States, you know, I've always been so impressed by how y'all pretty much have, you know, just kind of kept your style. The same way that NWA kicked the door in for Los Angeles, you know, in terms of really bringing it to prominence, although they were not the first LA rappers, they were the first to make it big. The Bay Area had a sound that was distinctly different, but it still had their own story as well. And from there, you all were able to craft something that pretty much was your own identity. You were in Los Angeles, and a lot of people got to understand that there is a distinct difference in terms of the sounds, the rapping subject, you know, content, the delivery in terms of how Southern and Northern California get down, putting it down on the rhyme, you know, and it's like,
right.
You know, to see all this, you know, I mean, like I said, going back to E-40, I mean, if a lot of these youngsters also, too, don't understand where Captain Sabahoe came from, E-40.
Right. But see, that's the thing, though, with the L.A. and Northern California and Southern California. It's like, you got to remember, all that stuff came out of the struggle of gangbanging and, you know what I'm saying, that type of stuff. And the Mexicans and, you know, you see a lot of the, with the Lokes and the khakis, that's a Latin culture thing. And somehow it filtered into the gangsters, the brothers, and you know what I'm saying? So it's different down there than it is up here. Up here in the North, man, it was more players, pimps, hustlers, that type of thing up here. We don't gangbang in Frisco. You don't have that. You know what I'm saying? It ain't no colors. It ain't no I'll be wearing all red. I mean, I'll be wearing all blue, yelling blood, blood, blood all day, and that's what we do in Frisco. And you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And them dudes down there, it's just a different. They stuff came out of the struggle of AK-47s and shooting and blah blah blah, and telling the messed up stories of the streets. But from us, you get songs like Pimp of the Year. And
oh yeah, I mean Drew Down.
Good weed songs, because all the good weed is up here.
I got five
here.
On it.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
you get good weed songs.
Yep.
You get the Loonies. You get Burner. You get, you know what I'm saying? It's a difference. I can say we're a little bit more laid back and like more play up here. They more aggressive and, you know what I'm saying, hardcore down there. I'll say that. They are. That's the difference between Southern California and Northern California. And it's a trip, because the Latins and the blacks kind of work with each other up here. The younger ones do.
Mm-hmm.
Down there, they beefing with the Latins. And you know what I'm saying? They trying to straighten that out down there. But we got it together up here. It's different. You know what I'm saying? We live amongst each other. Like, because it's relaxed, it's players, it's real cool up here. You know what I'm saying? Like I say, man, we got that good up here, that weed, man. That's why the songs are how they are. Players, you get Pimp of the Year, you get certain songs like that that come from the Captain Save-A-Hoes and shit like that. Because of that, down there is more aggressive. That's why you get F the Police and, you know, them type of songs. 6 in the Morning, you know what I'm saying? That type of stuff. That's the difference between Northern and Southern. That's the way I see it. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely. I think also, too, as well, you know, it's a different dynamic from where, you know, and obviously without getting too in-depth with it also as well, you know, the Mexican Mafia started in Los Angeles, California juvenile system, you know, for listeners who may or may not know the history of it, you know. And that kind of set the whole tone for the, you know, for La MA in Los Angeles and all that.
Right.
It kind of, unfortunately, it developed that tension between black and brown.
Right.
And, you know, over the years, you know, and of course up in Northern California, you know, I mean, a lot of people don't even know there is a differentiation, you know, between the Norteños and the Serranos. You know, Serranos is Norteños is Northern California.
That's so crazy, man. That old situation. I deal with a lot of Norteño cats, like, to this day, from Hayward, California. I deal with these cats, Calico Entertainment, my boy Diesel and them. They got their thing going, man. And I wonder why I never really dealt with a Serrano crew, but it ain't really none up this way, you know? They all Southern.
Right.
You go past Salinas or something like that. I forgot what it is. You get to there, that's when the Serranos start kicking in, you know, that part of California, and then you're down south, you know what I'm saying? So it's the difference, man. And them dudes, man, they see each other, man, it's on sight. They ain't even got the – man, I took these dudes to a show, man. Check this out. We went and did a show somewhere, and I took these dudes with me, man, and they seen a cat with a Dodgers hat on and some blue jeans. Oh, man, they was ready to hop all on this cat, like, on sight.
Oh,
I mean, we can't do that. We not here for that. You know what I'm saying? And the dude wasn't even – he was square. He was a nerd. You know what I'm saying? I just like the Dodgers, man. I'm sorry. You know, like, we was like, come on. I said, man, y'all can't do that, man. So I had to sit them cats down and explain it. And when y'all out here pushing this music, man, y'all got to look all that. Yeah. You got to look at that as a potential customer. You can't look at that as your enemy. You know what I'm saying? When you're out here on this road. So I had to have a nice little hour conversation with them cats about that. So they understand now. But it's like, dude, y'all got to change y'all way of thinking. Y'all
going
to be selling these records.
But it's serious when you got the Dodgers fans, because it's like, you know, it's full on between the San Francisco Giants and the Los Angeles Dodgers,
man.
Even in terms of, I mean, it's like, I mean, you know, my prayers to the dude that, you know, he got drunk some years back. And it was crazy because it's like, there's like really a rivalry between them with that.
Oh, man, it's almost bad as like that Northern Southern thing, man. It's on site, man. It's F the Dodgers all day long. We can be 0-163. As long as we beat the Dodgers once, that's all that matters. It's crazy. Crazy.
Man, that's wild, man. But eventually, you know, we about to go on to the second hour. We're going to bring in our second guest. Is there anywhere that people can find this up-and-coming project?
Man, the project going to be available on iTunes and everywhere else through Empire Distribution. I'm just, anybody want to reach me or get anything from me, I got my my entertainment email address you can hit me at. It's at drunktc@yahoo.com. One more time, drunktc@yahoo.com. So if anything you want to ask me or find out or send me, I DJ too, you want to send me some music, drop it off there.
And then any
shout-outs
you
want to
give out?
Oh, man, my boy Fleetwood, man, for just helping me, man, put this thing together, man. And shout-out to you guys, man, for having me, for real, big time.
No doubt. I'm trying to get Sandman back, but he been having some phone problems. Let me see if I can get him
back.
Sandman? Man. Yeah, he been having a little phone issues. He been hearing real noises. You there, bro?
He'll be back.
Yeah. We'll bring him back.
Oh, man, it's all good,
yeah,
though, man. I got to
say. Yeah, man, we definitely appreciate you joining us, man. You're welcome to come back next time, anytime. Well, we
thanks for the
to
love, man.
That single.
Hey, oh, yeah, man, I got my hit song when I do that, man. Yeah, we're in VA, Virginia, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah, Eric's in North Carolina, and I'm in Virginia.
Okay.
I hit you on the Facebook. So check your friend request, and you'll see me.
Cool, man. Because, yeah, my daughter was in the Navy out there in Virginia. I used to come out there and kick it a little bit.
Yes, sir. I'm in Hampton Roads area, so she's probably out here in the Norfolk, Chesapeake, Virginia Beach area.
Yeah, she was in Virginia Beach. That's where we were.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Man, I appreciate y'all, man, though. Good looking out, man. And y'all will be hearing back from me within the next month.
Yes.
All right, man. Thanks a lot, man. Y'all keep it popping, all right?
Thank you so
much.